Hi, this is Isabel Litzler, the place to be to develop your skills and grow your potential. It's been a while since I said this tagline. I think it's really representing the channel very well, a place to be to develop your skills. And I hope you get the right information to find a job in Switzerland. So today I'm going to give you the three areas, fields of work where you can find opportunities in Switzerland and the type of profile that you need for it. So, starting with basically for me, the most interesting and promising area to find work in Switzerland, it's really the tech sector. So anything tech-ish, so whether it be engineering, software engineering, blockchain, anything around digital marketing, so anything linked to digital and tech, really, this is where the jobs of tomorrow are in my view. So if you're young right now and you're thinking, what kind of studies should I do? I think this is a good start. Again, you need to also practice on your own. When I interviewed Cyril a couple of days ago, he really mentioned that you need to train yourself on those things. And also the reason is it keeps changing. So by the time you do a degree, it's already a little bit old news. So tech is really an innovation sector. So you want to be the person who already understands things that are not actually in a course format yet. So for example, in cybersecurity, the best people who work in that space are people who are, you know, just on their computer trying to figure things out. And there's no real type of training that you will do that will say you're an expert. As he said, you can get the certification just to get some credibility and to be hired by big companies. You need it as a proof of concept type of thing. But really, most of what you will learn is just the trial and error and just being interested in solving problems online. And same thing with digital marketing, it's a little bit of trial and error as well. And by the time you actually take a course, you see that the market is already evolving to the newest thing. So really the way I train myself, for example, in digital marketing is to look at what other people are doing, to see how communication evolves. And I just make some notes of that and try to be always a step ahead. So if you're just copying people around you, you're not going to be really the type of employee who's going to be so special. So if you can offer me the same thing that I can get on the local market, I'm not going to be so interested. Now, if you have a little bit of a tweak to it, maybe when you do digital marketing, you add your own flavor in it, which makes it more interesting, then I might look at your resume. So that's it. You know, tech for me is the jobs of the future. It's really where you can find opportunities. People are not quite completely ready for it. And I think depending on where you worked before, you really need to start learning about it. Watch some training. I know on LinkedIn, there's a lot of training that comes with the premium package. So you can do those courses for free because it's included in your membership. So things like that is really what you're looking for at the moment. In my view, is try to get some of those online courses, especially the free or the, you know, not so expensive type of courses, so you can already see what it's about and understand it. So tech, in my view, is really number one. Number two is international organization work. So anything linked to the United Nations, the Red Cross, all these places, they hire globally, so you don't have to worry about the nationality part. They can hire globally. They have a lot of support positions that you would not find anymore in the private sector because it's shrinking. But in international development, you still have a lot of positions like office management, support, you know, clerical administration. So those things you can still find in international organization. Now you have to have the right profile for them. So just make sure, check the job boards and see how close you could be to those positions. I will link below a few job boards for international organizations so that you can check. But this is really where the jobs are in Geneva, especially. And number three, in my view, is anything linked to finance or accounting or tax. So, but mostly accounting and tax, you have a lot of family office in Switzerland. So they're looking for super accountants and administrators. So you need to be a professional, meaning you need to have some certifications in accounting. So whether it be CPA, which is the American standard, but it could also be, there's different standards for accounting in Europe, especially. So just make sure you have these certifications. It's going to make you a better candidate for most positions. So again, professional accountants, not the assistant accountants where there's little less jobs. People were, if you're dealing with, again, rich families and you want to do their administration, there's opportunities in Switzerland. Some of those might come via the network, which is a big piece in my training about networking in Switzerland. So, and really Switzerland is known for this. Switzerland is known for tax, accounting, finance, you know, banking, insurance. So all these places have a ongoing needs. However, at the moment with what's going on, there might be less positions, especially the clerical ones, you know, very administration oriented. So you need to come up with the extra where people would find that it's useful to have this position. So right now companies are going to look at their operations and say, what are the essential positions that we need to keep rolling? So if you're too admin, meaning you don't have the specialty skills, you don't have the training like a CPA or something like this, they might not need the assistant accounting, you know, type of position. So you just have to see again with the job boards, and I will link them below, you know, see how you match to the profiles. Now, something that will probably be across the board for any positions is languages. So it's the summer. If you have some time, you know, try to improve your French or your German to be a better candidate. Again, the idea would be to be a bilingual or trilingual, you know, really fluent, being able to speak in the language. But, you know, the closer you can get will always be helpful. It's showing also you're making the efforts. A lot of expats sometimes don't have the effort that they're making to learn the language. So it's all signaling that you're investing yourself, you're learning the language, you're following the process in Switzerland. And that leads me to my course, the 3-step to get a job in Switzerland and develop your network, you know, profiling yourself, having the right application and doing the networking so that you can find a job in Switzerland and be more successful than expats who are just doing the job boards, which is not enough in 2020. You need to activate more options. You need to find those people that will be able to talk to you about the positions that they may have and will never go online. So I have those things also in my Careerpreneur group where we talk about how to target people, especially online. This is really something of 2020 with what's happening now. You know, I can't really so much advise people to go to conferences anymore because it's really reduced, but you can do a lot online. And that's also what I'm teaching in my course and in my group Careerpreneur is really how to find, identify the people that you need, whether it be recruiters or professionals in Switzerland, and then how do you build that rapport with them so that they trust you, want to work with you, and it leads to more. That's the idea, is to transform the contact into something more, because a contact by itself is not very useful, but you want to turn that into a working relationship. So I hope this video was helpful. Feel free to comment below. Also, if you have questions, send them to me. I pick randomly if it's a good question. I may make a video out of it because I think it could be helpful for the community. I talk to you soon.